I was torn between calling this salad a salmon olivier, which would offend all the Russians, and a salmon niçoise, which would offend all the French. But then I thought about it and realized that no matter what I call it, somebody is going to be offended and leave me a comment in all caps saying that I have ruined the potato salad of their childhood. And these people feel very strongly that they should warn all the innocent viewers that this ignorant woman is misrepresenting their mom and their country and humanity at large. So this is my version of potato salad. Okay, everyone? So haters, back off. Let's start by choosing the right type of potato. We want the potatoes that will hold their shape but will stay soft and creamy even after cooling off. In the US, this type is Yukon Gold. If you live in another country, unfortunately, I don't know all the types of potatoes that you have, but any waxy potato will work in a potato salad. If you have options, choose a waxy potato that will cook up as soft and creamy as possible. You can use small ones or big ones. Small ones look cute if you cut them into little circles, but big ones are faster to peel. Boiling potatoes could result in unpleasant texture if they absorb too much water. How could that happen? Well, their skins could burst while they're cooking, and that's how it could happen. Or maybe you'll test them with a skewer to see if they're done, and what if they're not done, and they need more cooking. And through that little hole, a whole bunch of water can pour into your potatoes, making them taste watery and kind of mushy. So that's why I much prefer to steam my potatoes instead of boiling them. Put a couple of inches of water into a pot and set a steaming insert into it. It's okay for the water to poke through a bit. Add the potatoes and cover the pot. Turn the burner on high heat. When the steam starts to escape from the lid, reduce the heat enough so that the lid isn't rattling, medium to medium low depending on your burner, and cook until potatoes are tender. I start checking little potatoes after 30 minutes and big potatoes after 45 minutes. Since potatoes are rarely uniform, I suggest you test each one and remove them as they're ready. The potatoes are done when a wooden skewer or toothpick can go all the way through with no resistance. Cool the potatoes until you can comfortably hold them, make an X in the skin with a paring knife, and peel the skin off. I prefer to slice little potatoes and to dice big potatoes. What goes well with potatoes? Just about anything, so don't be afraid to improvise. Since I'll be using pickles in mine, I'll add about 3 tablespoons of pickle juice to them and a pinch of salt. But you can also splash them with vinegar or lemon juice and some salt. You'll be amazed how much salt potatoes need. If you like pickles or capers, they go very well with potatoes. I'll put in a couple of little dill pickles. If you're using capers, give them a rinse first, since they tend to be very aggressive, and only use about a tablespoon. Some onion is a must. I'm using red onion, but shallots or scallions would also be lovely. This is about a quarter cup of finely minced red onion. Since potatoes are creamy, they go exceptionally well with crunchy vegetables. Today I have radishes, but fennel is also lovely. I give up on measurements here. It's a potato salad, guys. Seriously, how many radishes you put in depends on how much you like radishes. Almost any soft herbs could work here. I'm using dill, parsley, and chives. But cilantro, mint, and tarragon would all be good. I would avoid hard herbs like rosemary, sage, and thyme. They would be too chewy. I also meant to put in some peas. I forgot at this point, but don't worry, I'll remember later on in the video. On to the dressing. 1 tablespoon of lemon juice or vinegar of your choice. 1 to 2 tablespoons of Dijon mustard. I like 2. 1 tablespoon of whole grain mustard if you have it. Mix everything together well. Then pour in a couple of tablespoons of olive oil while whisking, just like making a salad dressing. Add 3 tablespoons of mayo. I like Hellmann's, and no, they're not sponsoring this video. And 3 tablespoons of sour cream. Mix it all up. Season with salt to taste. And pour over your salad. Add some freshly ground black pepper. And mix very thoroughly. This is where I remembered about the peas. I like to use defrosted frozen peas. The potato salad of my childhood, the Soviet classic with the French name Olivier, used canned peas. And that was understandable. Those were the only peas we had, and even those were hard to find in the stores. I think potatoes and peas together are fantastic, but I much prefer frozen peas to canned peas, and I think we all have frozen peas nowadays. I also much prefer salmon to boiled beef that is so common for Olivier. The salmon could be cooked any which way you want. Mine was grilled since I was shooting a grilling salmon video that day. Just make sure to cool it before adding it to the salad. Mix it all together, taste, and adjust the seasoning with more salt and lemon juice as needed. And last, but very important step, is to let this salad sit in the fridge for at least an hour or overnight. It tastes so much better once the potatoes had a chance to absorb some of the dressing. Besides tasting great, this potato salad is also one of the most versatile dishes I know. It's basically a complete meal that could be cooked a day ahead and doesn't even need rewarming. I serve it for parties as the main dish or as the only dish for completely stress-free entertaining. I pack it on the plane when we travel if we don't want to eat airplane food. And I even pack it in box lunches for my children for school. So this is really a little salad that could. What do you think we should call this salad? Make it so that you can get properly inspired and then leave me a comment. Of course, if you're properly inspired already, you can leave me a comment right now. A huge thank you to all my Patreon supporters for making my videos possible. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. I wish you all the most wonderful rest of the summer, and I'll see you in the fall. No videos for a few weeks because I'll be on vacation.